course of God's plan take its course as God prophesied, and the Antichrist will step out. But I'm here to tell you, friend, I believe the church has got to be gone. It's the remnant, it's the element, it's the Spirit of God still moving in the hearts of men and women that are holding back the darkness and holding back the Antichrist. But when he who now letteth is called, the Antichrist will step out, and all hell will break loose on the earth, called the Great Tribulation. And Daniel told us about this. Daniel chapter 9, he talks about the time of Jacob's trouble. Tribulation is not meant for the Gentiles. Tribulation is meant for the Jews to bring Israel back to God. And I'll get to the times of Gentile here in a minute. But he talked about 70 weeks, 70 of sevens, which is 490 years of time, revealing the time of God's people, the children of Israel. In Daniel chapter 9, verse 24 through 27, says, 70 weeks are determined upon thy people and upon thy holy city to finish the transgression and to make an end of sins and to make reconciliation for iniquity and to bring in everlasting righteousness and to set up the visions of prophecies to anoint the most holy. And know therefore and understand that from the going forth of the commandments to restore and to rebuild Jerusalem unto the Messiah, and the prince shall be 7 weeks and 62 weeks, and the street shall be built again, and the wall even unto troublesome times. Even then, after 62 weeks, shall the Messiah be cut off. And so what he's saying here at 63 weeks, it will begin, the beginning of the 70 weeks, begin the decree of Persia King Artaxerxes in 463 BC, and it ended when the Messiah was cut off in 483, year 69 week ended when Jesus was put to death. And so therefore there left a span of 7 years that have not yet been fulfilled, but yet there's been this big gap of over 2,000 years, which we call the church age, which we call the time of the Gentiles. So we see Daniel's vision, the 70th week, begin when Ezra come back and he started rebuilding the temple, and it ended when Jesus was crucified, and it was 63 weeks. But that last 7 years, that last week has not been fulfilled yet. And I believe that last week is the 7 years of tribulation. But there was a span there, 2,000 years. Prophets couldn't see. Amen. It was a mystery to those. The church was a mystery of godliness to them. Paul began to see it. The New Testament disciples began to see it. But the old saints could not see that gap. They could not understand what was going on. But I thank God for that 2,000 year gap. I thank God Jesus, amen, brought the Gentiles in and grafted us in. And it was, we notice the church age. It's the age that we're living in now. It's the age that the church was birthed on the day of Pentecost, and we're still preaching tonight in 2008 in March, because of that last 7 years has not started yet, but it will start when the church is gone and tribulation begins. I'm glad to know tonight that God thought enough of me to give me a span to get right. He thought enough of you. Hallelujah to God. He said, I'll create a church age. And I'm grafting the Gentiles. I'm grafting the black, the white, the yellow. Whosoever will, what can have the good blessings of God and inherit everlasting life that Jews didn't want it. I'll give it to you.
Oh, amen.
Woo!
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah to God. He thought enough of you. He took time out of history and grafted you into his plan.
Oh, amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
So when the Messiah cut off, till now there's still 1 week that God showed Daniel, which was 7 years, that has not been fulfilled. And it will begin when the church is gone.
Yes.
And tribulation starts. And the Antichrist steps out. And he deceives the Jews. He makes a pact with them. They sign a treaty. Yeah, this is our Messiah. He's got the answers to all the problems. Hallelujah to God. He's the one we need. But back midway through tribulation, amen, everything's going fine. Then he says, well, I've got them hook and sinker now. I've got them swallowing the whole line. They have accepted me. I'm going to make myself as God. I'm going to sit inside the temple, the abomination of desolation. I'm command them to worship me. And right then they threw up a little screen because they said, hey, we know enough Bible to realize it and ride. It's going to be a shame that those go through tribulation. It's going to throw up, they know enough Bible. Amen. They're going to see what's going on and know what's going on. But I'm going to tell you, I don't want to be going in this world there in tribulation. But I want to go the way of the rapture. I believe in the premillennial second coming of Jesus Christ. Amen. To catch us away from this world. The dead in Christ will rise first. Then we which are alive and remain and shall leave this world together. You read Revelations from chapter 6 on, I believe. There's 7 vials, 7 seals, 7 trumpets.
Amen. Amen.
And it all begins the wrath of God
right.
upon the whole world
right.
to bring Israel back to God.
Amen. Amen.
The times of Gentiles now. Would Gentiles be saved during the tribulation? Some say yes, some say no. I don't want to be there to find out.
Right. Amen.
This is the time of the Gentile.
Right.
This is the Gentile grace dispensation.
Amen. Amen. Thank
you. And if God keeps it open through tribulation, thanks to a merciful God.
Amen.
But if he don't, he's dealing with Israel.
Right, amen.
The two witnesses, the olive branches, amen, are going to die in the streets. Amen, and people are going to see them all across the world through their TVs and the satellites.
Right.
They're going to be looking down. They'll probably be on YouTube or whatever people look at, and they'll watch them two witnesses die. We killed them prophets, man, over God. But on that third day, they're going to rise up and they're going to see God's glory manifested, because God cannot be stopped by the will of man or by the devil. His course of time will always, amen, run out in his perfect time schedule, his perfect day. Amen to God. At the end of the 7 years of tribulation, there's a battle of Armageddon that's going to take place, and all the kings and all the nations are going to rise up to try to do war against the enemy, against the Lord of glory. But you know what Enoch said, that the seven from Adam, hallelujah, the Jews, as he began to write down, the Lord coming back with 10,000s of his saints, and he does war with the Antichrist, and he slays the devils, and he slays the nations, and there's blood up to the horse's bridle, because God will always overcome the devil and man. And I'm here to tell you, I plan on riding back with him on that day. And he's going to set up his kingdom. And those who have been faithful over a few things, he'll make you ruler over many. You don't want to miss that ride back from heaven. Woo! Hallelujah to God. Wayne Horton said the Lord showed him in prayer one day, Jesus coming back on the white stallion. And all the saints are coming back on the white stallion. He said, the Lord even showed me my stallion's name.
Hallelujah.
Woo!
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you,
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Thank
Hallelujah.
You. Hallelujah. I don't know the name of my stallion.
Thank you, Lord.
But I hope by the grace of God I have one.
Amen.
Can I plan on riding back?
Oh, yes.
And doing war with the Lord to destroy the Antichrist, the beast, and the false prophet.
Oh, yes.
And when we come back and defeat them, they're going to be bound alive and cast into the bottomless pit. There's fire and brimstone.
Amen.
Then Christ's 1,000-year millennial reign will begin.
Amen.
And if you've been faithful over